it's me. Listen, I'm sorry for the things I said earlier on. It's just, God, I really don't think you should go to that place. I don't think they care. Not like they should. And before you think it, I know how it feels to want to feel safe, to want more. You know I do it, but Jesus, do you know how they view you? Just another patient to squeeze money out of. Please, don't go tonight. I'm freaking scared. For you and for me.
In the mid-19th century, advances in genetic and psychological sciences led to a series of astounding breakthroughs regarding the human genome. At the forefront of these experiments, the Ishin Initiative discovered and developed new ways of mapping the human mind, expanding the knowledge of our species. 1942. Whilst the world was at odds with itself, the Ishin Initiative discovered Patient Zero.
Pure sleeve. I'll administer the first injection. And now, this might cause some slight discomfort.
And shortly after, the Ether Institute was born. With it, a completely new way to navigate the human brain. Projection. Allowing scientists to access areas of the conscious mind previously undiscovered by medicine, placing our scientific studies at the apex of modern technology.
Excellent. We're so glad to have you back. My name is Dr. Edmonds, but you can call me Phyllis if you like. Right. There should be a register on the reception desk. So once you've signed in, grab the key card from the top drawer and head on down. You will need it to gain access to the lower floors.
Restoration procedure for patient
JN205. 7.
We'll commence shortly. Staff are advised to prepare chambers for initial projection.
Well, it seems you best get a move on. There's plenty to do. And for you, plenty to see and discover. I'm going to be guiding you through the process of restoration this evening, and hopefully ensuring that nothing terrible happens to you or our client. I'm in restoration chamber number 3. Now, if you don't mind, would you be a dear and head on down?
Thank you.
Whereas these procedures don't, how should I put it, go to plan. But really, there's nothing to see here anyway. Shouldn't you be heading to Restoration Chamber number 3 to meet me? Ah, you know, we do tell them not to leave the pre-designated path, to stick to the memory routes laid out for them. But do they listen? Of course they bloody well don't. And unfortunately, recovery isn't always an option once you experience the deep recesses of another consciousness. Of others and a tool to cure disease and illness. But it would be nothing without the likes of you. Right. Would you be a dear and help me with the setup? I need the electrical input for the Rembrandt installation rerouting. You can access it from that terminal over there.
Clear this area of her mind from the plaque buildup that is causing the disease.
that from within, we're going to need to use her own memories to reinforce the mental treatment she's receiving. Surroundings. It keeps most restorers' sanity intact. For a short while, anyway. Our sole purpose this evening is to track the memory and pinpoint its location so we can cleanse it of any disease present. Everything you're seeing in front of you is a visual environment, pieced together from our client's subconscious mind. Barren wastelands or an abstract painting reimagined. It's all completely tangible. All I can see are brain scans of tissue degradation confirming my previous diagnosis of dementia. Both are incredibly important if we are to succeed and understand our client's needs. Now, if you just give me a second, I'll have some more details for you. Feel free to explore in the meantime. Readings indicate that the central focus of this memory is located below you, in an old abandoned mine known as Devlin. Entry 95D in our client's memory journal indicates that an accident occurred affecting them in a meaningful way. Thank you. Okay, so I've been digging a little deeper into our client's personal history, and I've found details of a strong emotional response to someone who once worked within the mine. An entry that discusses the mine at great length, but doesn't discuss whom the individual was that worked there. Continue to work your way down, further into the mine. It seems the center of this memory is very much at the heart of these industrial ratways. I'll contact you if I gain any more information.
Sounds, sights, and smells can help store memories forever.
A projector. I'm not sure how they got here, but I think they relate to our patient's history. Don't worry, you won't need these to progress this evening as they're an optional task, but we should at least give this one a try.
The things we touch throughout our life can stay with us in the back of our minds. Although broken and fragmented, they hold the key to remembering the way we were.
Oh, I hope that wasn't important.
A spray of perfume and it all comes flooding back.
I sprayed a small amount of the perfume that the next of kin provided on the back of the armchair. Although there wasn't any verbal acknowledgement at this stage, I found that the patient seemed to be calm throughout the entire session. I'm going to wash it off tomorrow and see if there's a direct difference, and if so, I may use it as an aid in future sessions.
I don't know where you are in there or what it looks like to you, but our readings have trebled in the last few seconds. You must be incredibly close to the center of this memory. I think... There it is. Our readings, they're showing that this is what's causing the symptoms of dementia in our patient, or at least it's part of what's causing it. Destroy it any way you can. Once the task is done, I'll be able to extract you from the memory and place you in another.
Stars are passing me by, burning so bright and so fast as if they never truly existed at all. They're so beautiful, so fragile. I want to hold on to them. I want to hold on and never let them go. Why can't I hold on anymore? Please.
Restorer? Can you hear me? Ah, there you are. I'm sorry. What you've just experienced was a relapse of our patient's condition. Hopefully you didn't cause too much damage whilst inside. Now, the objective as stated is to locate Jean's artifact. At this present moment in time, we don't know what this item is. We need to gather information from important memories our client can still understand. Their core memories.